Hi everyone, and welcome to another video by Wondershare Repairit, a one-stop solution that can fix corrupted or damaged videos and images, whether they're in MP4, AVI, JPEG, or many other formats. If you use Microsoft PowerPoint, you might have encountered the error saying PowerPoint can't open this file, or maybe your PowerPoint just won't open at all. It's common to experience this error, to have files not open at all, or even to encounter corrupted files. But don't worry, because today I'll show you how to fix them. But before we get started, let us know any other issues you're having with PowerPoint in the comments section down below. And don't forget to subscribe to the Wondershare Repairit YouTube channel. So if you're experiencing problems with PowerPoint, then you've come to the perfect place, because we're going to run through how to solve the most common problems. When you try to open a PowerPoint file and get the error message saying PowerPoint won't open, it means the file is either corrupt or the file has a problem that we need to fix. So let's run through the issues you might face while trying to access a faulty PowerPoint file. And all of these issues are related to the PowerPoint won't open error message. Malware or virus attacks on your system can cause PowerPoint files not to open, and can even corrupt them, rendering them unreadable. Malware can also alter or replace real data in your PowerPoint files, making them appear as icons with .exe files. One of the most common reasons for the error is a corrupted PowerPoint file. If you try to load the file and get the error message saying PowerPoint can't load this file, it is most likely due to file corruption, and the PowerPoint file will need to be repaired. Another reason PowerPoint might not be working could be due to a plugin or add-on. PowerPoint add-ons such as application VBA and comtypes might cause it to crash either without notice or with a semi-transparent window. When working with Microsoft PowerPoint, you might encounter unexpected behavior. This could be caused by a faulty presentation. If this is the case, you'll get error messages like "this is not a PowerPoint presentation" or "part of the file is missing." If you have access to another computer, try opening your PowerPoint presentation on that computer instead. If you still can't open your file, it's likely that it's corrupted. When a PowerPoint file becomes corrupted, it's missing crucial pieces of information that are important to open the document. Things like objects, graphs, hyperlinks, or even text. With this data missing, PowerPoint won't be able to open your file, resulting in the error message. So, how do we fix it? If you've downloaded your file from the internet, from another network, or from an email, Windows might have disabled the file and you won't be able to load it. Here's how to unblock your file. Right-click on the file to open the Properties folder. Select the General tab. If there's an Unblock button on the dialog box, select it. Click OK to complete the process and then relaunch the PowerPoint presentation. Sometimes though, unblocking the PowerPoint file might not resolve the problem because you're not sure if the PowerPoint program itself is broken or not. So it's best to disable the protected view in PowerPoint. This fix depends on whether PowerPoint itself is broken or not. If it's not broken, you can disable protected view and see if it solves the problem. Open the PowerPoint presentation, click on File and choose Options. Choose Trust Center from the left-hand menu. Then select Trust Center Settings. This is where you turn off the protected view feature. Choose Protected View from the left-hand menu, and then uncheck the three boxes on the right-hand side. Once you've finished, click OK. Hopefully this method fixes the problem, but an even simpler method is to load PowerPoint in safe mode. This method allows you to edit a corrupted file, even if some formats are missing. It opens your PowerPoint in a very basic view, allowing you to edit, and here's how you do it. Launch the PowerPoint software while holding down the Control key. A pop-up will appear asking if you want to start PowerPoint in safe mode. Select Yes to proceed, and the program will run in safe mode. For confirmation, look at the open program to see if it launched in safe mode. However, even if you can load your PowerPoint in safe mode, it's best to check the status of PowerPoint. This will help in determining when the problem first occurred. It's also useful for determining which files have been corrupted, the time period before and after the corruption, and whether or not the file auto-saved a backup. Open PowerPoint and select File. Under the Recent section, you'll see a breakdown of how you've been using the application and the tasks you've completed. Sometimes your presentation will be so corrupted that you will need to repair it, which brings us on to our final strategy. This is the best method to try when it comes to PowerPoint files not opening. To repair our PowerPoint files, we'll be using Wondershare Repairit's file repair software, and it will repair all the issues we've mentioned and recover our files. Select the Add File button and choose the presentation that needs to be repaired. You can add more than one PowerPoint file if required. Then all you need to do is click on the Repair button. After the repair process has completed, just save the presentation in your preferred location. But make sure you save the file somewhere different to the initial location. The Repairit Photo Repair tool can also assist you in repairing damaged Photoshop files with ease. Well, that's how you repair damaged or corrupted PowerPoint files. If you're having trouble with PowerPoint, hopefully one of those methods will help you solve the problem. And Wondershare Repairit's file repair software for PowerPoint is the most effective way to get your PowerPoints working again. Thanks for watching this video, and please let us know if you're having any other problems with PowerPoint not opening files in the comments section down below. And don't forget to give this video a like if it helped you, and subscribe to the Wondershare Repairit YouTube channel for more great videos. I'm Dan, and I'll see you next time.